Hello, Charahoe community. This is Gina Picard, the superintendent for the Charahoe Regional School District, and I am sharing the most recent presentation regarding the district's capital improvement plan. I am speaking as a spokesperson for the district's Necessity for School Construction Committee, as well as the district. I have presented at our schools, our town councils, and during public school committee and subcommittee meetings. This presentation reviews our current proposal for the state-required capital improvement plan that all districts must submit every 5 years. Based on the current facility needs of Charahoe, we will need to go out to bond regardless of the selected plan, as the work that is needed specifically in our elementary schools is a significant investment. After a rigorous stage one application that reviewed our current facility needs, it was determined that the most cost-effective and educationally sound approach would be to finance the construction of 3 new elementary schools, one in each town, and then finance prioritized projects for the main campus located on Switch Road. It's important to note that Charahoe must spend $1.8 million annually on maintaining school buildings. That's pursuant to Rhode Island general law, with or without a bond. How does this number get figured in? It must be 3% of your operating cost. And for Charahoe, that comes up to $1.8 million. The next few slides will show you some of the current infrastructure that is in need of repair. We have specific needs that must be prioritized. This includes electrical, plumbing, and HVAC. The district has been developing plans based on the needs of our aging elementary facilities dating back to the 1990s with Superintendent John Peeney and later in 2005 with Superintendent Barry Ritchie. It is unfortunate that for over the last 25 years, there has been no significant investment in the facilities of the Charahoe Elementary School schools in comparison to the investments made on the main campus. And it's not for lack of trying. Unfortunately, both presentations, both projects were defeated. And our schools continue to age. They were constructed for a very different type of learning that occurred back in the 1930s. You can clearly see that this is dated and in need of repair. This slide shows you the most recent flood for Richmond Elementary School. Problems like this cannot continue to persist, and we have an opportunity to get a large reimbursement and fix this for once and for all. Investing in state-of-the-art learning environments is more than just constructing buildings. It's a profound commitment to fostering excellence in Rhode Island education and Charahoe. We all know this is not free money, but to be clear, the taxpayers in Hopkinton, Richmond, and Charlestown have already funded educational projects across the state of Rhode Island. Here are the communities that have not yet benefited: Charahoe, North Kingstown, and South Kingstown. We all have upcoming votes on May 7th. It may be interesting to know that all three towns overwhelmingly approved this 2018 general election Rhode Island School Buildings Bond. A yes vote authorized $250 million in bonds over 5 years, with no more than $100 million issued in any 1 year. So it would be careless of Charahoe not to put forward a plan where the taxpayers have an opportunity to benefit from the very bond that they approved. So if you look at this slide, you will see bond option A. That's the bond that the district and the Necessity for School Construction Subcommittee is putting forward. That would provide 3 new elementary schools, one in each town, along with our main campus projects. Some of those needs are our career and tech roof, middle school skylights, and our high school breezeways. That would be at a bonus rate of 76 to 81% reimbursement. And these reimbursements are temporary. If bond option A fails, we would have to consider bond option B, which means we would go back to the voters in the fall and our base rate of 61% reimbursement. That would be simply for prioritized projects focused on health and safety things like plumbing, HVAC, and electrical are the highest of priorities. If both bond option A and bond option B fail, we would be forced to move to emergency needs only. So, like I mentioned, we are eligible for temporary bonus points. That means that we could get up to 81% reimbursement for our projects. However, those bonuses end February 15, 2024. We use conservative numbers to ensure that we were not undercutting what could possibly happen. So if we have a bond of up to $150 million, that means Charahoe's responsibility would be $28 million, or $2.3 million annually, with up to an 81% reimbursement. Principal and interest are both eligible for reimbursement. How did we get to the 81%? Well, health and safety provides an additional 5%. Educational enhancements provides an additional 5%. And newer and fewer provides an additional 5%. If we can get the replacement cost, that would be another 5%. That means that one of our buildings, right now we are looking at Richmond, would be ready for reemplacement, and therefore we would be able to receive the 5%. Why should Charahoe invest in new construction versus our current elementary facilities? This is something that's been asked. Well, is this a need or a want? We can assure you, this is not a want, this is truly a need. Our elementary schools were designed for 1935 education. Most of our teachers would be happy with just more than one or two outlets to charge their Chromebooks and power their technology. But is that really enough? Is that the commitment we want for our schools or for our students? The cost to build three new schools will be the same amount annually, regardless of the plan. This is why we wanted to make sure that our town and our taxpayers understood the opportunity that exists. With new construction, not only would we be able to design facilities for 21st century needs, we would also be able to provide new furniture at $2,100 per student and new construction at $3,000 per student. That is based on RIDE's formula for new construction. We recently went to our town councils. This is an example for Hopkinton taxpayers. You can see that for bond option A, if we were to look at a 20 to 25 year bond at an 81% reimbursement, that would be a $28 million overall cost to Charahoe. That means Hopkinton's cost would be $879,980. That's because of the 1,123 students that Hopkinton currently has. If your home is valued at $400,000 right now, that would result in a $269.59 per year increase. What happens if we go to bond option B and bond option A fails? It's the exact same cost. And what happens if we go to option C? It's the exact same cost. Now, this slide shows you the impact to Richmond and Charlestown and shows you all three towns together. We already went over Hopkinton. Richmond at a $396,000 home would result in $256.50 per year. And Charlestown for a $578,000 home would result in $75.14 per year. These numbers are based from our member town finance directors on the current assessed value of their homes and their current enrollments. Now, we just recently found out that interest rates have already dropped. These numbers are based on higher interest rates, which means the numbers are due to be much lower. This slide simply shows you the same thing I just reviewed, just with the finances. So like we said, $150 million bond, the state would pay $121 million of that. Charahoe would pay $28.5 million over 20 to 25 years at approximately a $2.3 million cost. You can see below the share of the member towns overall, and then individually by taxpayer, by household, you will see the increase. And again, that is a very conservative number, and we do anticipate that decreasing. We've also been asked about what happens if we only get 76%. Well, we did that for you as well. 76% reimbursement over a 30-year bond would be about $2.3 million. 81% reimbursement over a 30-year bond would be about $1.7 million. And again, this is really about sharing an opportunity that exists so that our taxpayers have the chance to say, what would you like us to do? Continue to maintain our aging facilities or build brand new? Now, you may be asking the same question that I asked. How is it possible for bond option A and bond option B to be the same amount? As you can see on this list, these are prioritized health and safety needs. These are not wants, these are needs. And there are a couple of items like middle school HVAC, which we still are getting a finalized number, but it's at least $1.7 million. And if bond option A fails, we would have to resubmit elementary projects because we would have to determine the level of scope that we wanted to renovate or repair. As you can see, the total of just this list is almost $6 million. At our 61% reimbursement, that's 2.3. In the community, we're hearing this is not free money, and that is absolutely correct. And I mentioned this earlier. These funds in the towns have already been voted on and approved in a 2018 vote. For over 30 years, Charahoe has made attempts to keep up with our aging facilities. And unfortunately, we know that we can't continue doing the same thing. It is going to be cheaper than renovation. It's going to be cheaper than maintaining. And in essence, we're going to get brand new schools for our students. We're also hearing schools like Harvard have old buildings and they renovate. How are they doing it? Well, that's interesting. Doing some research, we found out that the Mass Hall on the Harvard campus is 300 years old. And for the HVAC that they recently put in 2018, it cost them $13 million. And that building was 22,000 square feet. Richmond Elementary School is 53,000 square feet. So if we were to give that same overview of how much it cost for Harvard, that means the Richmond School back in 2018, just for HVAC, would cost us $30 million. If you consider inflation, that's about $40 million. That's nearly the cost to the new Richmond building that Charahoe is proposing for new construction. We're also hearing, let the school and the district focus on reading and math and not these capital projects. Well, the fact is we must do both. We can't not do health and safety for our kids. And we must ensure that education is at the forefront, just as health and safety should be. We are proud of our elementary schools. They are the best in the state. Ashway's a 5-star school, Richmond's a 4-star school, Charlestown's a 4-star school, and Hope Valley is a 4-star school. All our schools are doing tremendous and making great gains. Recently, Richmond not only had the Milken Award winner, but it was named a RICAST Rockstar for the most growth in math and ELA. This shows the current timeline. We submitted our stage one back in September. The school committee finalized the bond legislation January 23rd. On February 15th, we will submit our stage two application to RIDE. And again, stage two is required by law in order to make sure you have a 5-year approved capital improvement plan, also required by law. Our goal is our spring 2024 bond vote, May 7th. And then if the voters pass the bond, we will go under contract for these new projects beginning June 30th, 2024. Here's a schematic from our architects from SLAM. This is not the buildings that we will get. This is an example of the kind of building we could get. Their job as our architects is to maximize and show us our dollars and how they can be spent and how we can develop the plans. This is not to give us the exact building that we want. That only happens in stage three, and that only happens if the voters vote yes. Then we would hire an architect, we would hire a project manager, and we would design the actual buildings that we would want, and we would get continuous community input along with our educators, families, students, and taxpayers. So what's the goal? Honestly, it's to share this opportunity. And it would have 100% of our Charahoe Elementary students in new buildings by 2029 for the same annual cost of prioritizing maintenance. We have additional information on our website. We have a frequently asked question document. You can also submit a question if you don't see it noted on our documents. Please reach out if you have any questions, we are always happy to respond, and we hope you will consider this project as our Charahoe Elementary students and the communities depend on it. Thank you.